pandemic, social distancing, coronavirus. You guessed it, we're currently in quarantine. So today, we're gonna fly the TBM900 on Flight Sim from Opa-locka to Nassau in the Bahamas. Here we go.
Buddy, we're here in the TBM900 and X-Plane 11. We'll turn the battery on here. Put the generator to main. All right, while the systems are coming up, we'll put the park and brake on. That's our master caution warnings all coming
on. Warning, okay.
We're going to push enter here to get our systems going. We'll get ready to start the TBM here. We'll go out there and tell them to pull the chocks by our virtual marshaller. Take a look down here at the systems as they're all coming up. Our volts look good on the battery. So 25.6. Yeah, so we're good there on the battery. So we're going to do a battery start here with the TBM900. We're going to come up here. Ignition is going to go to on. Boost pump on. Come on down here. Make sure everything looks good in the enunciator panel. Now we're just going to click up on the star, on, and release. Now we're going to come down and watch the NG to rise up and stabilize. There we go. Now we're going to go up over this gate into low idle. Now we're going to have light off. Now we're watching the NG for hung starts and ITT for hot starts. And once the NG gets right up here into the green, we'll be able to continue the start cycle and the flow. Come up, ignition will go into auto, boost pump into auto, fuel selector to auto, turn the autopilot, trims on, come on down here, turn the bleed on, put the AC on, and come over here, inertial separator on. And there's our caution light for the inertial separator, it usually takes about 30 seconds or so.
Opa-locka executive information hook.
We'll get the ATIS here.
1900 Zulu weather. Wind calm. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 20,000 scattered. 35,000 scattered. Temperature 14. Dew point minus 15. Altimeter 2992. Arriving runway 30. Departing runway 30. Advise on initial contact you have hotel.
All right, we have information hotel. So the exterior view, this is where we're at, sitting on the ramp right now at Signature Flight Support at Opa-locka. All right, so now that we're ready to taxi, we'll go up here, turn on our taxi light. If there was a marshaller out there in front of us, he would know we're ready to taxi. We'll give ground a call real quick. Opa-locka ground, November 851 Tango Bravo. Going to be approaching spot 3, ready to taxi with the information hotel. And we would get our virtual taxi instructions. Now we'll go look at 4 flight down here, and you'll see this is where we're at on the diagram. We'll taxi via Papa Echo Tango to runway 30. Come down here and we will release the parking brake. We're ready to go. Yeah, I'd like to welcome everybody on board. I mean, with how crazy it is with the coronavirus going on, the pandemic, we're all kind of self-quarantined right now. There's Signature Flight Support right over there to our right. And we got to watch out for that fuel truck out here. So yeah, we're a good way to stay current and keep up on your skill level is with Flight Sim. And this is X-Plane 11, and we're using the Hot Start TBM900. Actually, I'll tell you one thing I forgot to do that's very important here, guys. Notice the sound level. We come down here and click on our Bose 20 headset. Listen to the difference. Got a lot quieter. So crucial step, put the headset on. So yeah, we're using the Hot Start TBM here. an X-Plane 11. And the computer system that I have is from Jetline Systems, which they're based out of Tampa. I did a video going up to pick up the sim a while back. I got the Virtual Fly, the Yoko Plus Yoke, and then I also got the Virtual Fly TQ3 Plus Throttle Quadrant and the Rudo Plus Rudder Pedals. And it's a really good setup with the sim here. And most likely on this departure, we're going to get a heading a 310. What they would do in real life. There we go, set up. And we're gonna go up to 2,000 feet initially. So if you look down here at the iPad again, you're gonna see us there. We are coming up on Echo. This is where we're gonna turn left. And then the next taxi will be Tango. And then we'll turn left on Tango and that'll bring us right to 30. There we go, we got the, we're heading mode, then we have it set for 2,000 feet with the command bars pitched up to 10 degrees, so that'll be all set. So once we go flaps up and the yaw damper on, all we have to do is hit the autopilot then, and whoa, watch out, little tug, man. The thing with Sims is you got to be on your toes around here. See that guy, he wasn't even going to stop for us. So yeah, we're going to go fly over to NASA. It's going to be a, let's see here, if we look down at four flight, this flight will take 34 minutes. Come to the exterior view here. There we are taxiing on the center line. With any airplane you fly, I always try to see exactly where you want the center line to be on the dash. So when you're taxiing, you know where to look for to keep your, you know, on the center line. And with the TBM900 here, right in this area right here is the perfect spot for the center line to be placed when you're sitting in the seat. Get ready for this departure. We'll put flaps set to takeoff setting. You look down here, you're also going to see it is indicating. All right, so here we are holding on short of 30. We'll announce our intentions. Since it's kind of an uncontrolled airfield, we'll just treat it as that for our radio calls. Walk of traffic, TBM. We're taking off 30, departing to the northwest of walk of traffic. All right, so we are clear for takeoff. Put our light on. And we'll put our strobes on. That was our four flight app. Telling us exactly how much we have remaining of runway. There we go. We are all set up for takeoff. So we'll line up here on center line. Windsock, you can see it might have a little bit of a right crosswind on this one, but it's pretty much calm. So here we go. We're going to ease the power up. On the prop governor, now we advance the torque for takeoff power setting. There it is, we'll hold it right there, watching for our rotation speed. Right, and there it is, so pull back on the yoke, and there we go. Pitch up to those, the flight director there. Push a little trim down. Come down here, gear up. Okay, your gear is up. Now we can come down and put the flaps to up. Selected. Now you're also looking right here. Make sure it's also indicating. And it's indicating. Now we're going to put the autopilot on, along with the yaw damper. 1,000 feet to go. Take a look outside. So in this area, we're leveling out at 2,000 feet. We'd normally be told to turn to a 090 heading and climb and tame probably 5,000. So putting our heading bug over to 090. There we go, and we'll set that to 5,000 feet. And we'll go into VS mode, climb about 2,000 feet a minute. You can see the Atlantic Ocean out there. And there's Opa-locka off our right wing. Now if you look down here at 4 Flight on the iPad, you're going to see there we are, just off Opa-locka, and that's our routing today. We're going to do the beach transition, And then we're going to go into Bama, Ray J, and into NASA. That was 1,000 feet to go. There's an airport over there. Beautiful day to be flying out to the Bahamas, virtually. So with the flight plan here, we want the second leg to be the active leg. So we're gonna hit the cursor here, scroll down to the beach intersection, and we're gonna go menu, activate leg, enter. And if you go out of the flight plan and we zoom out, that'll be the leg that we want active, where we're gonna capture. So we zoom out. See, now we have the leg from Fort Lauderdale, VOR, out to beach. That's the beach transition. So since we're going eastbound today, we're going to pick an odd altitude. We'll go up to 15,000. So we're going to put 15,000 in our altitude preselector here. And we'll once again VS it. And we'll go up. Do it 2,500 feet a minute. Now we can also turn off our inertial separator. I'm going to show you guys something. So down here is the inertial separator switch. We're going to toggle this off. Now you're going to get a torque rise and an ITT drop right here when you do this. So you always want to have the torque down a little bit so you don't get an over torque on the engine. So here we go. Inertial separator comes off. Now it usually takes 30 seconds to cycle through. Now watch, you're going to see as the scoops and the flaps in the engine intake open, you're going to see how you're going to get more torque and the ITT is going to go down. And for the completion of the inertial separator, usually, like I said, it takes around 30 seconds or so. That's why I always want to pull the torque back a little bit when you go to turn the inertial separator off, because you'll get this rise. And we'll pull the power back just a little bit. As you can see, if we weren't on top of that, we would have had an over torque. All right, so ATC would probably be telling us right about now, 851 Tango Bravo, turn left to 060 to intercept the beach transition. So that's what we would be doing now. So we'll take the heading bug. 060, and we'll now also go into nav mode. Now the airplane, once we get this to load, we're going to go right towards this to intercept the magenta line. And we'll also go into flight level change mode. That's going to pitch us right for 137 knots, so we won't have to worry about the airplane stalling out. We're out of 10,000 feet. Turn the landing light off. As we're in the climb, we can continue to advance the torque right here, and we won't have to worry at this altitude. We're going to be torque limited. We won't be ITT limited here. If we were going up higher, you would be worried about getting ITT limited, or you wouldn't be able to advance the power anymore because of the ITT. But today, since we're going to be staying down lower, torque is more of our limiting factor, so that's what we have to worry about. I'm going to have to take this plane into the shop, I believe. As you can see, we have a fluctuation with our the elevator trim. See how it's kind of like bouncing a little bit? It's also right here. I've noticed that in the last few flights with this. So after we get back, we will bring this over to TBM and have the mechanics look at it. So here we are. The horse is coming in here. Now we should see the airplane capture that and turn right since we're in nav mode. Coming up on 1,000 to go. 14,000. I'm in the 15,000. So there we go. We're in the turn. And now we're on route to NASA. Square up the heading bug. Give it a little quick tap in the middle of the button. Brings the heading bug right to your heading that you're currently on. We're now leveling out at 15,000 feet, which will be our cruise altitude. Look down here at the iPad again, you'll see there's the green line. It's our little breadcrumb trail or where we, our course has been that we took off, and there we are. If you look here, you'll see this is the ADIS line that we're about to cross. That's where you definitely want to have squawking your transponder and a flight plan on file to cross in and out of the United States airspace. So to stay ahead of the flight, it's always good to get things set up. So we'll put in the ATIS and the ground frequency and the COM2 down there. I'm connected to the VATSIM network right now. There wasn't any really controllers where we were at today, so that's why we're just doing what we're doing on our own. So one of the first islands off the coast of Florida here is Bimini. That's it right over there. The airport on Bimini is right in this area. And to get to the north side where all the resorts are, you'll take a taxi right to this area. You'll take a little ferry that gets you across that little canal area. And then this is where all the resorts and the restaurants are, all right over in here. There's actually a sunken ship right over in this area. It's called the Sipona. Great area to go snorkeling. Ran aground there many years ago, and it's a big old concrete ship sitting there on the surface. So you go check it out and go snorkeling around. It's really pretty cool spot. All right, so we're just over beach. Now the airplane is gonna be going to Bama, which is our next fix. Now we're gonna get set up to cross the Ray J intersection, which is right here at about 1,000 feet. So we'll get 1,000 set up in our altitude preselector here. And when it's time to go down, we'll start down to cross Ray J right around 1,000 feet. That's, I believe, is normally what they would give you in real life. I have not flown to the Bahamas yet in this sim, so this is one of my first times. I actually just got back into it after many years. And what better time to get back into it to be with this quarantine going on currently? I hope you guys are all doing well wherever you're at with this. I mean, it's disrupted the whole world. And my flight schedule with my full-time job, if you're new to my channel, I fly airplanes for a living. And the TBM850 I fly, our flight schedule is currently in a holding pattern. So I've been getting back on flight sim has been really helpful, you know, getting to shoot the approaches and the procedures. Landing and taking off is, you know, not as realistic as a real airplane, of course. But when it comes to looking at the approach plates and actually getting to have ForeFlight hooked up right to the sim, if we take a look here and you actually look at the iPad, you're going to see, I mean, look at it, matches right up ForeFlight. So when you're shooting approaches and everything in the sim, it's looking at your approach plates and the different charts. It's as 100% as realistic as real life. Here we are. We're coming up on Bama. Now we're going to get a turn to Ray J. So we're in the turn. We'll go to exterior view here. There we go, that's cool. I like that view. So if we look at the map here, you're gonna see right on this is Grand Bahama Island with Freeport. I've done a few videos in there in real life, and also West End. If you look through my library here on YouTube, I've done some videos in and out of there. Got Spanish Key way up here at Mike Yankee Alpha X-Ray. And you got Treasure Key, this is all on Abaco Island. Then you're gonna have Marsh Harbor right in this area. And right here is Great Harbor. Then you have Chubb Key. Today's alternate on this flight is what we have listed as right here, Chubb Key. And the reason why I picked that is Chubb Key is, you know, within a fair distance of our destination, and it has customs. This is also San Andros down here on Andros Island. Andros Island is one of the biggest islands in the Bahamas, but there's not a lot on it. But all on the eastern side here, there'll be some resorts for bone fishing. And also you have missile range right over here on the east side of Andros Island, where submarines do a lot of training with the Navy. There's real deep water in this area. It's called the Tongue of the Ocean, I believe. Then down here is the Exumas, and On the next video I think I'm going to do on YouTube with you guys and the TBM here, we'll take the TBM and we'll go from Nassau down to Staniel Key. That's my favorite spot in all the Bahamas right here, Staniel Key. Take a look around here. This is the fuel selector down here. It's automatically on an automatic timer, goes left and right. You got your circuit breakers down here. And this is your environmental control system panel. The pressurization and everything, and the air conditioning and the fan speed. What's nice is all the pressurization on this airplane is done automatically. This is your little panel right here. Currently have a cabin altitude of 3,900 feet. Differential pressure of 4.4. Get back in our seat over here. Shouldn't be up walking around the cabin, should we? And we'll also square up the heading bug. So see how the heading bug is over here? So instead of having to turn the knob, if you just tap it, boop, goes right in place. All right, we'll start our descent down to 1-1000. Go into VS mode. And set that right on down to 1,000 feet a minute. Now, since we've started our descent, we'll have to watch, because now that you'll get a torque climb as we go faster through the air. See, it's going up, so we're going to pull back power just a little bit, so we don't have to worry about getting an over-torque on the engine in the descent. If you guys are thinking about becoming a pilot, online stuff is the way to go, since we're all on a self-quarantine here. Go over to my friend Jason Shepard, M08.com, link in the description below. It's an online ground school he runs, and also has a book, The Private Pilot Blueprint. It's a free book that he wrote. All you have to do is pay for shipping, and kind of guides you along to getting your ratings. And now's never been a better time to do online content, because a lot of flight schools are closed down. There we are, 1,000 feet to go. 1-2,000, descend to 1-1,000. So it is a really nice day out there. I mean, if you look out the front, you'll see that's Andros Island, where I told you all the good bone fishing was. Over to the left here is Chubb Key. That's our alternate right over here, where they also have customs. And Nassau's starting to come into view over in that direction. It's nice, but anyway, I think it'd be good to keep up on our approach plates here. I'm going to come down to the iPad here, go to the approach, and I say we'll take the RNAV runway 32 right here. And since we're coming in from the west, we'll take Hidno as our initial approach fix. So what we're going to do is we're approaching Ray J here. We're going to go down here, and we are going to go to procedures, select approach, and right down here, scroll down to the RNAV 32. And there's our initial approach fix that we said we wanted, which is Hidno. And let's see, what were the minimums on that? Minimums were 330. We're going to go to the barrow. Put in 330 right there. And we will load that for right now. So we're going to want to cross Hidno at 2,000 feet, so we'll start down for that. And we're going to go VS. And we'll go 1,000 feet a minute down. There we are over Ray J. Turn in direct NASA. And since we don't really want to go direct to NASA, we'd rather go direct to our initial approach fix. So there's the NASA airport's like right in here. The initial approach fix that we're going to go to is right over in this direction. So we're going to actually activate that approach. We're going to scroll down procedures. And we're going to scroll up to activate approach. Enter. And now the airplane is going to be turning direct to Hidno. Right over here, this direction. In real life, there's an old airplane crash right over in this area right here. I think back in the 60s. I forget what the cause of the crash was, but it's sitting right over in there in real life. And we're going under 10,000 feet. Put the landing light on. Check our pressurization. Looking good.
Lyndon Pindling INTL, Nassau, Information India. 1900 Zulu weather. Wind calm. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 20,000 scattered, 35,000 scattered, temperature 14, dew point minus 15. Altimeter 2992. Arriving runway 32, departing runway 32. Advise on initial contact, you have India.
All right, we got India. We got in range of the ATIS there. So it's going as planned. We got lucky. We set up for runway 32, and that's what they're using. And we can give the tower a call here in case there is any online controllers here. I believe there wasn't any when I checked on, but we'll see if there's anybody there. NASA, good afternoon. TBM 851 Tango Bravo. No, there's nobody there. So we'll just treat it as an uncontrolled airfield. Take a quick look in the back here. Usually that's where Reggie would be sitting, but he's not here today. We can pull out the tray table here. How cool is that? Put that back in there for landing. You can also control all the shades. This TBM is about as accurate as it can be for realistic of how it is. There we are. Our airport is going to be right over in here. So we're going to come right around here and do the approach right on in. It's 1,000 feet to go. NASA traffic, you have a TBM about 20 miles to the west. We're going to be shooting the RNAV 32 approach for NASA. Alright, we're leveling out at 2,000 feet. See, it's green and it's captured now. 2,000. Anytime you flip a switch or a button, you always make sure the airplane does what you wanted it to do. See, here's the approach. And if we had to go missed, it's going to be a right turn out here. Parallel entry into the holding pattern. So we're going to slow it up. We'll pull the power down here. Back with the lever down there, you'll see. Got to get that airspeed under 200 knots. And then we'll put that inertial separator on. Right there, looking at the airspeed. There's 200. We can now flip this switch. There we go. Then, like I said, around maybe 30 seconds, a little give or take, a little more, a little less. You'll get the master caution on. And on the annunciator panel down here, CAS, they call it, you'll see inertial separator on. If you look down here at the approach plate again, you'll see there we are, blinking away, coming into HIDNU. Or HIDNO. That's where we're going to turn left. Cudley. Then once we get to Cudley, we can go down to 1600 feet to intercept the glide path over Dilby. There we are on the turn right here. See right on the approach plate, we're doing the same thing. So that's why it's really cool how 4Flight connects to these simulators like this. There's our inertial separator right here on the CAS. So next stop is Cudley. Here we are, now we're over Cudley. Now we go right on down to 1600 feet. Put that right in there, VSA down. And we'll pull the power back. And we'll keep it under our first notch of flap speed for the limitation. And since we're under that, we will put our first notch of flaps in. Right on down here, we'll select it. We're going to also watch and make sure it indicates. Indicating. You can actually see the runway already in sight out there. We're going to use Odyssey Aviation on this airport, which will be off to the left. We're going to be looking for the glide path to come down. When we get one dot above, we'll go gear down. So once this comes down, gets right around this position, it's like one dot above, that's when I always go gear down with the gear. Currently 1.4 from Dilpy. There we go, it's coming on down. Glide path. Set our torque right around 25. Right in here. One dot above. Down, and we will put the gear handle down. So gear selected. You get the knob's gonna blink red. You have this unsafe until all three green. Perfect. So gear is down. Now we can go right on down to 330 feet. We can actually disconnect the autopilot right here. Can't let the airplane have all the fun flying this thing. So we're within the speed limitation. We'll go flap selected to full. Also gonna look here and make sure it's indicating. And it is. So we're gonna be pitching for around 85 knots. 4 Flight told me we're on a 2-mile final. Looking good, and we'll make an announcement. Nassau traffic, TBM, 2-mile final, runway 32, Nassau traffic. See that building over on the left of the runway? That's where Odyssey Aviation is. That's the FBO, and we got customs there. We can clear in there and be on our way. We're looking good, a little bit fast still. Pull the power back just a little bit. Beautiful day. Actually get rid of that flight director.
500.
It's 500 feet to the ground. We're looking good. Right on the glide path, right on the approach course. A little bit to the left. Don't judge me now, guys.
Minimums
at 330 feet. You don't judge me. I'm pretty good at landing airplanes in real life, but flight sim is a little bit different. And I'm still pretty new to it, being back in flight sim. There's the road over there to the right that'll bring you downtown once we land. Alright, we'll start to pull the power back here. And go into the flare.
Airspeed.
Here we are, so we'll go back into beta. In reverse, slow it up, we're on centerline, so that wasn't bad. And there we are, welcome to Nassau, Bahamas. So this is runway 28, so we'll turn left here on 28, and then we'll taxi via Kilo into the customs ramp there, an Odyssey. And we'll clean the plane up here once we get off of 28. So here's Kilo right over here to the left. And that's where we're going to turn left right here. Here's our taxi sign, Kilo. We cross these hold chart bars, we'll come to a stop and clean the plane up. Alright, we'll come to a stop right here. This looks good. Alright, so we're going to clean this plane up here. Turn off our stall heat. Come up here, put the taxi light on. Strobes off. Come over here, we'll turn the bleed off. We're gonna reset our trims and put the flaps up. Selected. And then reset the trims here, right here, which will be over here on my yoke. So I'm gonna put the takeoff to green, rudder trim over into the green. And the airline trim is set perfect too. So there we go. So everything's set up and cleaned up. Nassau traffic, TBM, we're on Kilo, taxiing the ramp, Odyssey ramp, Nassau. Alright, so yeah, welcome to Nassau. Hope you guys enjoyed that flight. I know it's not a real airplane, but it was still a lot of fun to have you guys on board inside the sim here with me. Definitely some tough times that we're all going through together here in the world, so I mean, I hope everybody's really doing well. If you did like that video, please smash the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel. And I think the next sim flight we'll do will be in the TBM. We'll go down to my favorite place in the Bahamas, Daniel Key. That'll be a little bit more challenging of a landing, as the runway is only around 3,000 feet. It's narrow. And it's a beautiful area in real life. Probably won't compare anywhere near in the sim. But so this is Odyssey right up here in front of us. This is customs right here, the Odyssey FBO. And when you always come in here to park, they'll bring you right up here to the cones. This is actually pretty accurate. They do have these shrubs here. When you taxi out of here, the airplanes go right along those shrubs, and sometimes the wings are pretty close to clipping them. But this is Odyssey Aviation. Normally, there would be a marshaller right here telling us to come on in to park. Take this spot right here is where they would normally put me in real life. Try to put our front tire on this line right here. A lot of pilots always take pride in right in that area. And we'll come to a stop right here. This looks good. Up here. Light off. Put a parking brake on. Come to the over panel here, we'll do our flow. There we go. All right, guys. Anyway, hope everybody's doing good, and we'll talk to you again someday soon. Take care.
Get along. Do.